Hey everybody, it's no more toxic people. I'm gonna lay my phone down over here in the seat and I'm gonna talk as I'm driving. I'm sitting here at a red light waiting for it to change. I don't have but a few minutes. I'll be pulling into my job. This guy just walked out right out in front of me. I guess I was in the crosswalk, I don't know, but anyway. I just sat there looking at him like, what's he doing? But anyway, I come to make a quick little video. This doesn't really have to do with narcissism so much as what's happening in our country right now. And I'm not getting into politics. I'm not here to talk about this group or that group. I'm here to talk about all of us as human beings and what we... One thing that I have had on my mind very strongly for the last 6 or 8 months... is human trafficking, and we really all of us, no matter who you voted for, no matter who you support, no matter your income level or your, you know, whether you are anti this or pro that, human trafficking is happening, people, and I think that it is only going to get much, much worse. I've said this since back last year. I said, you watch with, and especially now, and like I said, I don't want to get into politics, but you have to admit that the open borders and these people pouring into our country, some of these people very well probably are trying to better their lives. They're coming here hoping for an opportunity. The American people are not getting much of an opportunity. In my state, Kentucky, we're still, you know, we still have a lot of businesses that are limited. And our governor is trying to enforce these mask mandates and things that shouldn't even be in place anymore. But I, like I said, I don't want to get into politics, but I want to talk about, here I am stopped at traffic stop number 2 with this road construction and tree cutting. It's ridiculous. But human trafficking, man, people better watch. And I'm talking about if you have children, you have to make your children, and I don't even care if they're 1 year old or if they're 21 years old, 31 years old even, you have to tell people where you're going. You have to tell people. When you leave a store, you text somebody. I'm leaving Walmart right now. I'm getting in my car. It's 2:06 p.m. I'm getting in my car. I'm starting home. I should be there by this time. And I know that sounds over the top, but I'm telling you, this stuff can happen in the snap of a finger. And I'm not even kidding. You can be walking out of a grocery store, walking out of a department store with a bag, walking to your car. You know, you're distracted, you're looking at your phone, you're getting your keys out of your purse or your pocket, and you can be grabbed and snatched and taken in a matter of seconds, and it happens every day. And it's only going to get worse, because like I said, these people coming in here, some of them, a good majority of them are probably hoping for a better life, hoping to come in and reunite with family maybe that's been here for years. And others are here for drug running, drug trafficking, human trafficking, other types of criminal activity. And I'm not saying this, you know, like I said, political, I'm not getting into it. But people, I don't care if you're my age, I'm 53 years old. You tell people, and you take somebody along with you. Now, I know... women, you know, I'm talking mostly women here, but men too, and especially young people. Young men and women in their teens and 20s really need to be talked. This really needs to be talked about more. I know everybody likes to go out and have fun. I used to when I was younger in my 20s. I went out to clubs with my friends, and sometimes we would split ways during the night. One girl may meet somebody and want to go off to a party or go up on a date or whatever, but you can't do stuff like that anymore. You can't leave a club and go with and say, oh, there's an after party over here at this house, I'll go. Even if two or three go together, you can't even be sure then what's going to happen to you. You know, I'm not saying take away all your fun, but you really have to pick and choose your fun. You know, you have to pick and choose. And alcohol and drug use and stuff like that can inhibit, it can take away our inhibitions, it can take away our fears and our worries, and we don't think nothing bad's going to happen to us. These people are great. Well, we don't know, you know. And I hate to see this. And the way things are in our country right now, we may never even know that this is happening, because so much is being covered up in the news. So much is being hidden. There used to be shows like Nancy Grace and these shows like that, where they would talk about these missing women and children. They would get on TV every evening and they would bring you a whole hour show. You know, this person's missing. Here's where they went missing at. Here's the last time they were seen. You don't even hear about stuff like this anymore. And it's happening more now than it was then. But you don't hear about it, because they're too busy focusing on COVID. They're too busy focusing on the government and all the stuff that, you know, the backbiting and fighting and people saying this and that. Our country, man, our country's in real, real trouble. And I'm not even talking about all the political stuff that's happening. I'm talking about the human aspect. We've lost our humanity. We've lost our concern for our neighbor. We've lost our concern for our fellow man. And I'm just here to say, keep your babies close. You have to make them your job. Your job can no longer be your priority. Your activities, after work activities, running to the grocery store, running here, running there. You have to make sure that you have a babysitter or someone with your children that you trust. And we all know that sometimes even the most trusted people are the ones that end up, you know, harming and causing us, you know, that we think we trust these people. But you know who you can trust. You know a grandmother or a sister. You have to create a network. You have to create a network of moms and aunties and older sisters. And you have to know the men in their homes. You have to know who they're hanging out with. No more days of hiring a 15, 16-year-old babysitter to come in and watch your kids while you go out. You have to have them with a trusted adult, someone who is not bringing in every Tom, Dick, and Harry that they meet at the club to hang out and live with until he gets tired and moves on, because you don't know what their motives are. Many, many pedophiles and child molesters choose single moms for the sole purpose of getting close to their children and molesting them, or even kidnapping them. We are living in a different, I mean, we're living in the same world, but it is going to get worse, people. And I'm telling you, we're going to see record numbers of missing children and missing women. And these human traffickers, there's someone you should look up on Facebook. If you don't know this person, go look him up. Tim Ballard, B-A-L-L-A-R-D. He was, I want to say, I'm not in front of my computer, so I can't reference right now, but I'm pretty sure he used to be a police officer. And he was going in and finding missing children, and he decided to start his own detective agency type of business. But what he does is he finds children, missing women and children, who have been sold into sex trafficking. Many, many people he finds have been taken out of the United States. He has gone as far as Russia and other places where he has found people that have been trafficked. And look him up and read about him and read about the work he does. There's going to be more and more of this happening, and we really have to be on our toes. Young women, moms, dads, aunts, uncles, everybody, grandparents, you need to really talk to your young people, your children, your grandchildren. They really need to know about this stuff. You really need to tell them after, you know, you get out of school of the day, when you have ball practice, volleyball, track, basketball, whatever, you need to know, you don't go and just get in the car with someone's, you know, someone says my uncle or someone's here to pick me up. You don't just go and get in the car with them and go. You have to tell who you're going with. You have to get their license plate number. You have to say what time of day you left and where you're going to be and where you're going. You have to know these things, people. And I'm not saying this to scare people. I'm saying this because this is the new normal. Everybody wants to talk about these governors and these politicians, these CDC and all this. They want to talk about COVID, and this is the new normal. But this is going to have to be the new normal for all of us. You talk about tracking. When all this first started, this COVID and everything, all you could hear about was signaling, or whatever they call it, where you, virtue signaling and stuff. They wanted to know who you were, you know, they were tracking your phone so they would know who you were going and hanging out with. And so they could kind of watch, you know, they said they were doing it for so they could know what areas needed to be better monitored for COVID. I don't believe that. I personally believe it's just a way to track human beings. I believe a lot of this has to do with facial recognition and being able to see how well they can track us as human beings. But they can't even find missing women who go missing from a fucking nightclub. And 3 months later, her body's found down over the fucking hill. Now, you tell me that they don't fucking know ahead of time that that girl had her fucking cell phone with her. They knew who she was with and where she was at. So why don't they use this fucking technology that they've got for good? Some real good. Like finding missing children and women. And that's, and I know I get heated about it, and I use my voice and I start to say things maybe a little too loudly, but it's true, and it's what we need to be watching. And I'm here at my job now, and I'm getting ready to pull in, but I really just wanted to talk about this. I've wanted to talk about this for a long time, and I'm telling everybody right now, if you hear this video and you watch this, if you have children or young people in your life, you really need to start watching them a little closer, watching them a little better, knowing who they're with and where they're at and what they're doing. And, you know, they're not going to like it. Young kids are not going to like it, but if you're a young woman yourself, you really better start telling people who you're with, where you're going. And you need to learn self-defense. Everybody does. Everybody from my age down needs to learn self-defense.